A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 19th July, on the front page you have Karnataka CM asked to prove majority by 1:30 PM today. So government's fall appears imminent as governor has set a deadline and the rebels are going to skip the session. So this is the development in Karnataka politics. Then this is Supreme Court to hear Ayodhya title dispute case from August 2. So a mediation panel had been formed which was asked to submit its report by 15th August, but now it is said it has to submit its report by August 1 and the title dispute is scheduled to be heard on 2nd August. So related to Babri Masjid, there are two cases, one the criminal case going on as such on demolition of Babri Masjid, and this is a title dispute case on who owns the property as such. Then below you have Finance Ministry expects no flight of FPIs on higher tax. So we had seen how the taxation has been increased for high net worth individuals, which affects foreign portfolio investors too, because many of them are, you know, treated as trusts, which are treated as individuals. They are trust treated as individuals, so they have to pay taxation as per the tax slab. So higher taxes there are affecting investors in the country too, foreign portfolio investors. But then the Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman says that no flight of capital is expected and companies won't be hit. On page 2 you have government has ignored benefits of cannabis, claims plea in High Court. So there is a petition which has been filed before the Delhi High Court which says that there is not a single document which shows that cannabis is lethal to humans. So this is a social cause legislation which has been initiated to bring an end to various existing laws in India that prohibit and criminalize use of cannabis. On page 5 you have Sonbhadra killings, SC-ST panel orders invocation of NSA, National Security Act. So the UPSC-ST panel, the SC-ST commission, has asked the state government of Uttar Pradesh to invoke the National Security Act and Gangster Act against culprits behind the killing of 10 tribal people in Sonbhadra district, and action should be taken against officials for their negligence in averting the massacre too. On page 8 you have suspected treasure hunters vandalized tomb in Hampi. So this is the Vrindavan tomb of Shri Vyasaraja Tirth, a renowned saint of Madhva tradition. It's near Hampi. It has been found razed and it is one of the 9 such Nav Vrindavan on the banks of Tungabhadra river, which has been, you can see, vandalized. It is suspected by treasure hunters. So recently also we had seen how the World Heritage Committee had also raised the concern regarding the Hampi World Heritage Site, and now this vandalism case comes. Then this is Chandrayaan 2 set launch set for July 22. So now Chandrayaan would be launched by July 22. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a reprieve. So this is regarding how Pakistan must recognize India's resolve in securing the safety of Kulbhushan Jadhav after the judgment of International Court of Justice too. And the second editorial is the threat of Ebola. So we had seen yesterday in news how World Health Organization has declared a health emergency with respect to Ebola in Democratic Republic of Congo. So now there's a need to counter the risk of global spread of the disease. Then the lead article is inappropriate template for a legitimate target. So it says the economic survey, it invokes the East Asian model and rightly calls for a rise in private investment. So it calls for a rise in private investment and incongruously invokes the East Asian model. So economic survey either glosses over or ignores many acute challenges faced by the Indian economy, like the severe agrarian crisis or the troubles of loss making and debt ridden PSUs and the issues plaguing the public sector banks. So it is, you know, it has been, these are issues are being ignored, and survey is not incorrect in highlighting the importance of incorporating insights from psychology and economics, but it has been done so quite late is what the article says. So this is the complete article on, you know, how tight financial oversight where is being seen in the East Asia model. So an East Asia model of growth has been proposed. that is being studied here and a comparison done. And this is OIC, Organization of Islamic Cooperation, curious record on Xinjiang. So the OIC grouping as such. So the foreign ministers meet of the OIC took place recently in Abu Dhabi in March 2019. So this article says, while OIC has made repeated references to Kashmir, it has been ambivalent about China's treatment to Uyghur Muslims in Xinjiang. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have this Parle coverage where an issue is, where a question is raised and views, counter views given. So this is, does the anti-defection law serve any purpose in Karnataka political crisis? So the law is actually against the principle of representative democracy and needs to be reformed is also highlighted, how the anti-defection law needs reforms. So this is an important issue. Then on page 12, you have finance bill clauses irk Congress. So government has introduced amendments to many laws unrelated to finance in the finance bill, which is part of the budget being passed. So this is important. On page 13, you have Pakistan espoused Khalistani agenda. So India in a dossier has mentioned 30 instances of Sikh pilgrims being subjected to anti-India propaganda. So this is also an issue which has long been connected to the Kartarpur Sahib, Gurudwara in Pakistan. And this is CM's panel mulls move to tie state farm reforms to funds. So this is chief ministers who have discussed ways to bring state governments on board. So here you can see the group ways steps, including scrapping the ECA, so which is there for food. So that is the Essential Commodities Act, which applies for food. So you can see, to usher in sweeping reforms to boost agriculture growth, a panel of chief ministers discussed ways like possibility of linking the adoption of reforms to the Finance Commission's grants and allocations. Then on international page, here you have US bars Turkey from F-35, the F-35 fighter jet, stealth fighter jet program, over the S-400 deal which Turkey has procured from the S-400 anti-missile system from Russia. And this is China-US feud rises over Taiwan. So China has threatened to sanction US companies over arms sales to Taiwan, which China considers as part of its territory, though it is independently governed. And this is Iran seizes tanker. US vows to protect sea route. So the tiff between Iran and standoff between Iran and US is escalating is evident here. And Iran has seized the tanker. It alleges the ship was smuggling oil. On business page, you have India may have to revise downwards potential growth rate from 7-8%. So this is ex-chief economic advisor saying today's 4.5% is impressive as size of economy now is 5 times of 1980 level. So this is a dispute regarding growth rate. And this is SEBI opposes center's proposal to transfer surplus money to CFI, Consolidated Fund of India. So SEBI says the plan will undermine its autonomy. And this is transmission sector needs 5 lakh crore investment for future needs. So this is Confederation of Indian Industries, which says that India is likely to consume 1.8 lakh crore units by 2025. So to become a 5 trillion dollar economy, an investment about 5 lakh crore is required in power transmission sector over the next few years. On page 16, you have interest subsidy subject to GST. So Tamil Nadu Advance Ruling Authority for Advance Ruling has given this order in this case related to a Daimler Financial Services India, in which it says that interest subvention income received as such is to reduce the effective interest rate for the final customer attracts a GST of 18%. So, and this is SEBI moots tougher disclosure for resignation of auditors. So auditors quitting abruptly have to be give a detailed reason. And below you have Center seeks response from Indigo and misgovernance. So co-promoter of Indigo, Gangwal, has leveled charges against Bhatia. So this dispute has now gone before the central government. It is seeking response on the matter. Then on the last page, you have 7,000 species added to IUCN Red List. So, habitat destruction and hunting by humans are the reasons for falling number of species. And now you can see that number of species are being driven to extinction at an unprecedented rate. So, more than 7,000 animal, fish and plants have been added to the endangered Red List of IUCN. So, these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.